一丁、教えてやろうぜ。 サスケ。
ああ。
I hope you guys do enjoy the Naruto and Sasuke adult versions. Naruto the Hokage and adult Sasuke. I really hope you guys do enjoy this. This did take me a while. Why can I not speak? This did take me a while to make. Sorry for taking this long. I did want to make this, you know, perfect and stuff because this is the part two. Like I said, I hope you guys do enjoy this. But yes, I just want to go ahead and talk about, you know, Naruto and Sasuke just in case, you know, dudes. Any confusion of the stats or whatnot. I'm not gonna go in detail of the stats. I'm just gonna go ahead with Naruto. First of all, I'm just gonna talk about his field skill and his jutsu, really just the main stuff, okay? Again, Naruto is a wisdom unit, yes. He has a field skill of ignores, defense, and cause damage 900 to 1200. Just like that, Tyrone, is that his name from the Ninja Road or PvP reward? Yes, he has that. Yes, PvP reward. Yes, he has that. So I did go ahead and give it to Naruto, but I did make Naruto do more damage. And of course, for the first time, I did decide to go ahead and put 15% chance to reduce chakra by secret technique to zero. So his body skill is a 15% chance to not use the ultimate jutsu. So if you put him behind any units, they have a 15% chance to not reduce the unit. The reason I have done this because one thing when I was making Naruto and Sasuke, I do want to make them units that can last, you know, forever in the game, that can be used even if they get weaker throughout the game, they can still be used for the body skill and stuff like that. So yes, 15% chance, so basically anyone in the game can have a chance to not use your jutsu, so it just makes him that more worthy to summon for. Also, again, let's just go ahead with the jutsu. He's 5 chakra, 6.5 times attack towards all enemies in range, and restores own chakra by 2, and 65% chance to cause 2 random status effects for 4 turns. So basically, what that means is this Naruto, he has 5 chakra, he restores chakra by 2, which is great. He can do this really quick again. The 2 random status effects, what this basically does is this Naruto can do any immobilization, jutsu seal, slip damage, attack weaken, any of the status effects, he can do any of them. He can only do 2 and they are random and it does last for 4 turns. The reason I have done this is because for the ultimate, as you can see, the ultimate, 18 times attack toward all enemies in range and gives all allies a barrier of 4000 and restores health by 2000. I know you all wanted the wisdom healer, so he is the ultimate wisdom healer. Each status effects applied on enemy causes an additional 2 times more damage. So what that means is, if Naruto does a status effect, or if anyone else in your team does a status effect on the enemy, that does give Naruto an additional 2 times more damage. So instead of 18 times, he'll do 20 times, or 22 times if there's 2 status effects on the enemy. But yeah, I mean, this could be kind of useless if the enemies cannot be, you know, immobilized or whatnot, but it is still really useful if you can go ahead and do this to certain enemies. And of course, he gives a barrier of 4000. I mean, barriers is really underrated in this game, and this Naruto, so the hitbox is the whole map, okay? So everyone gets in the hitbox, just like in the anime, Naruto protects the whole village. Shit, yes, he protects the whole village. And so that's what I basically went for, and he does heal 2000, so there's your healer. His abilities restores 200 to 400 health every turn, reduce damage by 20%, extends stats of ninjutsu secret techniques by 3 turns, restores health by 300, and reduce chakra by 1, so he's gonna be more broken, he's gonna be 4 chakra. You know, we gotta make this Naruto like the best unit in the game. And reduce damage by 20%, so he's really tanky and he can heal a lot and he can do so much damage. He's long range, I did not mention that, but yes, his PvP 41k and you know all that stuff, I don't really need to go over that. But yes, this Naruto was made for protection, basically to help out your whole team and just heal your whole team and again make him OP and do so much damage. But that is Naruto. Again, I wanted to make this video really quick for you guys, just, you know, to start any confusion. Let's go on to Sasuke. Alright, as you can see, Sasuke, he is a bravery unit, medium range. You know, all that health and attack, you guys know what that is. And field skills, this is a new one, okay, 15 to 20% chance to immobilize enemy when receiving attack, so instead of countering them back with a normal attack, he does have a chance to immobilize. I wasn't able to put how many turns, but if there was a turn, it would just be one turn, so he would be able to immobilize it for like one turn or 1 second or whatever. So it's really OP, but it's not going to be really, really game changing. You just basically stop them for like a one turn, really, which is kind of OP. But it's 15 to 20% chance. And his body skill, again, I did try to go with Naruto, make him last for a really long time, increase secret technique multiplier by 2, what? Yes, we're gonna go ahead and give this Sasuke increased secret technique multiplier by 2, so anyone in the game can do more damage now. The reason I have given the Sasuke this, because I wanted Naruto and Sasuke to really link up together, so Sasuke has a chance to now use his ultimate, and Naruto has an extra multiplier by 2, which is, I mean, Naruto's already strong enough, but Sasuke's gonna make him even stronger. And as you can see, he has 4 chakra, 8 times attack towards one enemy in range, and gives himself 1 random boost effect for 3 turns that causes knockback. So this Sasuke can give himself any random, but he can only give 1, and is a boost effect, so he can give himself attack boost, he can give himself whatever, any boost effect really, this Sasuke can do to himself, which is OP. And again, his ultimate 8 chakra, this is really new. You really need to listen carefully to this one, because no one in the game has something like this before, and it could really give off the wrong expression. What? I don't know the word. Give self perfect dodge for 4 turns, and the damage that was dealt in the last 4 turns does 40% back to the enemy. So basically what that means is, this Sasuke does no damage, okay? If the last 4 turns, if no one in your team does a jutsu or ultimate or any immense amount of damage, this Sasuke will only do 40% of that. And if no one does damage and you used ultimate on the Sasuke, he'll just give himself a perfect dodge. Now, you may think this might be a shaft, but it's not. This will make this Sasuke live on the game for forever, because how strong your team is, if you, in the last 4 turns, if all your team do ultimate jutsus, let's say it goes to 70, let's say Kage does 70k, Madara does 50k, whatever, they all do immense amount of damage, it goes up to like 200k, this Sasuke will do 40% of that back to the enemy. So no matter how big the damage is, this Sasuke will always get stronger in his ultimate, and it is 8 chakra, so you do need to be careful, this Sasuke can get really good. So yeah, again, I did want to make him last for a really long time. And let's go on to his ability, 20% chance to reduce chakra by 0, so, you know, he can, his first jutsu, he can, you know, has 20% chance of not using it, 13% chance to dodge attack, reduce damage by 15%, 20% chance to dodge attack, yes, we're going for the cancer, yes, I know, ignore barrier, substitution and perfect dodge, and boost attack by 300, yes, this Sasuke is really OP, as you can see. He can really dodge. The reason I have done this is because I just wanted him to be really cancerous. That is really all. I just wanted to make him really annoying in PvP and just games like that. You just go ahead and slap a Zabuza or the Minato behind this Sasuke, and you're good to go in PvP. But yes, okay, again, he has a boost attack of 300, so he will get really stronger. But yes, that is Naruto and Sasuke adult version. I really hope you guys do enjoy the art and the little trailer and the stars. And if you do make it this far hearing me talk about the stats, and I hope this all makes sense to you, the way I laid out these units, I do want to make them, I made them out of a way so they can last for a really long time or last forever, because this is Naruto and Sasuke, my boy. It's Naruto and Sasuke. We can't let them you know, get the shaft. But yes, I mean, again, if you enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, as I do so many of these kind of videos, I don't know what I'm saying. But yeah, before I do end this video, I just want to say is, I don't know what unit to make next. I don't know what fan art or unit to make next. If you, whatever you want to see, make sure you do comment it down below. I will be reading all the comments and replying to most of them as I can. Yes, whatever you want to see me do, you know, a fan art of, I will do that. I know a lot of you do want to see Asha and Indra. But if there's more, I'm happy to make Asha and Indra. Nothing wrong with Asha and Indra. I'm happy to make Asha and Indra. But if there's any other units you do want to see, make sure you do leave in the comments below. As I do, note them all down and hopefully we can get them all done. But yes, with that being said, hope you guys enjoy. Leave a like if you're new and subscribe if you're new. What am I saying? Shit, yes.